We want to use long division to find the quotient. We have a 3-digit number divided by a 2-digit number. For this example, instead of using the traditional long division algorithm, we'll be using the method of partial quotients. The first step is to write the division problem in long division form, which is this form here. So we have 624 divided by 26. When performing division using partial quotients, to keep our work organized, we'll draw a vertical line to the right of our problem. We'll record the partial quotients on the right. Before we begin, though, it's often helpful to write some products that we know involving the divisor. In this case, let's write some products involving 26. For example, we know that 1 times 26 is equal to 26, but because our dividend is in the hundreds, let's also find 10 times 26. Well, 10 times 26 is going to be 10 times more than 1 times 26, and therefore 10 times 26 equals 260. Let's find two more products. If 1 times 26 equals 26, then maybe we can determine that 2 times 26 is equal to 26 plus 26, or 52, and therefore 20 times 26 would be 10 times more than 2 times 26, and therefore 20 times 26 is equal to 520. We should be able to use these products to help us determine this quotient. To begin the method of partial quotients, we always consider the entire dividend, in this case 624. We need to determine a certain number of 26s that we know for sure are in 624. Looking at our products, because 260 is less than 624, and 260 equals 10 times 26, we know there's at least 10 26s in 624. But if we look at 20 times 26, which equals 520, because 520 is still less than 624, we know there's at least 20 26s in 624. So we could start with a partial quotient of 10 or 20, but let's use the larger partial quotient of 20. So we'll put a 20 here on the right, and now we multiply by the divisor. 20 times 26 we know is 520. So we write down 520 below the dividend, and we subtract. So we have 401. So the difference is 104. So we just removed 20 26s from 624, and we're left with 104. And now we want to use 104 and determine a certain number of 26s that we know for sure are in 104. Well, looking back at our work, notice 52 is less than 104. And because 52 equals 2 times 26, we know there's at least 2 26s in 104. But maybe we also recognize that if 2 times 26 equals 52, then 4 times 26 would be 52 plus 52, or 104. And notice how, because 4 times 26 equals 104, this tells us there's exactly 4 26s in 104. So let's use the partial quotient of 4. Again, 4 times 26 equals 104, and we subtract. Notice how this difference is 0, which means the remainder is 0, and to find our quotient, we simply sum the partial quotients. So 20 plus 4 is 24. So this tells us 624 divided by 26 is exactly 24. Now, the nice thing about the partial quotients method is that we don't have to use the same partial quotients in order to find our quotient. So let's look at this problem again and use different partial quotients just to show we do get the same quotient. Let's say we begin by using this product to determine our first partial quotient. Because 10 times 26 equals 260, and 260 is less than 624, we know there's at least 10 26s in 624. Let's begin with a partial quotient of 10. 10 times 26 equals 260. We subtract. Notice after removing 10 26s, we have 364, and 260 is still less than 364. So we know there's at least 10 26s and 364. So let's use the partial quotient of 10 again. 10 times 26 equals 260. Subtract. After removing another 10 26s, we now have 104. And again, let's say we didn't know this product here, but we did know that 2 times 26 equals 52. Because 52 is less than 104, we know there's at least 2 26s and 104. Let's use a partial quotient of 2. 2 times 26 equals 52. We subtract. This difference is 52. And again, because we know 2 times 26 equals 52, there's exactly 2 26s and 52. So we use the partial quotient of 2 again. 2 times 26 equals 52. Subtract. And of course, we still have a remainder of 0. So because the remainder is 0, to find our quotient, we sum the partial quotients, which once again gives us 24. So because 26 divides evenly into 624, we know 26 is a factor of 624, and so is 24. We also now know that 24 times 26 equals 624, meaning 24 groups or 24 copies of 26 equals 624. I hope you found this helpful.